Westdale folks and in your worship spaces at home or wherever it is that you may find yourself this morning as you tune into our Westdale YouTube worship on Sunday, July the 5th, which is the fifth Sunday after Pentecost. Our prelude this morning is indeed a Celtic piece of music, a very up piece of welcoming Celtic music performed by a small local Celtic group, which includes our own Janice Davis. Thank you, Janice, and your group. It's good to see you and good to hear from you. We continue in our time of worshiping together as we light the Christ candle. This candle that is lit dances with the presence of the Spirit, reminding us of the warmth of community in which God calls us to gather, and the light that shines with wisdom, insight, and clarity for us in our time of worship. And as I light our Christ candle, our Brenda Shepherd will play for us, "Lord, Prepare Me to Be the Sanctuary." Worship this morning. The God of heaven has made a home on earth, and Christ dwells among us and is one with us. The highest in all creation lives among the least. Christ journeys with the rejected and welcomes the weary. Come now, all who thirst and drink the water of life. Come now, those who hunger and be filled with good things. Come now, all who seek, and be warmed by the fire of love. Our opening prayer. At the beginning of this day, we seek your presence, O God, not because you are ever absent from us, but because often we are absent from you, at the heart of each moment where you forever dwell. In the rising of the sun and in the unfolding color and shape of this day, open our eyes to the mystery of this moment, that in every moment we may know your life-giving presence. Open our eyes to this moment, that in every moment we may know you as the one who is always now. Amen. Our opening hymn this morning is from Voices United, number 330, "Jesus Shall Reign." Thank you so much, Brenda. It's good to see you and always to hear you. Today, our prayer of illumination and our scripture reading are offered to us by Peter Smith. Peter is indeed going to read for us our gospel lesson, which comes from Matthew this day, Matthew 11, 16 to 19, 25 to 30.
Good morning, everyone. So nice to be with you, even if it's away from you. It's my opportunity to provide you with the scripture lesson this morning. I'll begin with the prayer of illumination. Join me if you wish. God of mystery, you speak to us in stories, riddles, and metaphors. It's easy to pass them off as just stories or a clever joke. These stories are not jokes, but contain the real stuff of life. As we pause in our week to worship you, give us the clarity to unravel the mysteries in these stories, the heart to hear and feel these realities, and the will to live them. Amen. The scripture lesson this morning is taken from Matthew 11, 16 to 19, 25 to 30. Now, to what can I compare the people of this day? They are like children sitting in the marketplace. One group shouts to the other, "We played wedding music for you, and you didn't dance. We sang funeral songs, but you wouldn't cry. When John came, he fasted and drank no wine, and everyone said, 'He has a demon in him.' When the Son of Man came, he ate and drank, and everyone said, 'Look at this man. He's a glutton and a drinker, a friend of tax collectors and other outcasts.' God's wisdom, however, is shown to be true by its results. At that time, Jesus said, 'Father, Lord of heaven and earth, I thank you because you have shown to the unlearned what you have hidden from the wise and learned. Yes, Father, this was how you wanted it to happen. My Father has given me all things. No one knows the Son except the Father. And no one knows the Father except the Son and those whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all of you who are tired from carrying heavy loads, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke and put it on you, and learn from me, because I am gentle and humble in spirit, and you will find rest. For the yoke I will give you is easy, and the load I will give you is light."
Thank you so much, Peter. It's good to have you as part of our worship this morning. Our anthem this morning is a familiar piece that is going to be performed by Janice Davis and her small Celtic group. It's entitled, "Morning Has Broken."
Thank you.
morning, my reflection culminates what has been 3 weeks of going into Matthew's wonderful gospel stories in which Jesus shares with us learnings towards our becoming the full disciples that he calls us to be. So this morning, the title of my reflection is Learning Surrender. Surrender is the response that I imagine Jesus hopes to witness in us following his continued invitation to discipleship in Matthew's writing that Peter read for us today. In the verses before this, Jesus has been clear that divine wisdom is proved right by its results, and that he has a special relationship with God that he can choose to share with others. It is in this spirit that his powerful invitation to discipleship is issued at the close of today's passage in Matthew. In the scripture reading today, we listen to Jesus' final teaching to his disciples, learning to surrender totally to Jesus and his way. It is the final learning, so to speak, that Jesus wishes to impart to the disciples, that of them knowing that in their surrendering, his yoke is available to be put upon them. A yoke that offers gentle assistance in their time of surrendering to full discipleship. A yoke that strengthens the followers when they are weary from carrying the heavy load of walking in the way of Christ. A yoke that offers rest for soul, a yoke which is easy and light, full of love, care, strength, and guidance. A yoke that calls us to surrender to Christ in all the ways of our life, in all ways of our following, and in all ways when we need his presence to renew, to refresh, to lighten, to love, and carry us. One of the many marks of this call to discipleship is that we understand the deeply spiritual nature of our quest found in our ministries as Christ followers and in the concrete ways that we live out our faith. We find discipleship's foundations in the times of struggling for faith, love, hope, and justice as we accept the challenges and rewards of Christ's words of last week. Whoever welcomes you welcomes me, and whoever welcomes me welcomes the one who sent me. In this maturing and maturing once again, we discover God's wholeness as we seek to integrate our faith into our daily lives. This transformative discipleship is hard, it's necessary, and it can sometimes be lonely work. As we live into our discipleship, we must always remember that we are made in God's image. We are gifted with God's unconditional love, of which we are called to offer to others and to the world. God weaves the very fabric of our existence through that unconditional gift, always inviting us to share the rich rewards of God's grace and mercy with others. In doing so, we are called to live out of our possibilities and not our shortcomings by answering yes to God's what ifs. And as we do so, the love of God revealed in Jesus' ministry moves us to grow in compassion, understanding, and acceptance of each other. I picture the depth of learning that my grandson Avery is very much engaged in this time in his life. I referred to that learning of obedience a few weeks ago. The learning that I understand, which Avery is processing at this formative time in his life, is learning that teaches him to grow up, offering the unconditional love he knows and will continue to know from his parents, while giving that love freely to others as he matures. It is a love that offers a foundation of recognizing his possibility in life. It is a love that does not dwell on shortcomings. Rather, it is a love that calls him to say yes to life while always striving toward the what ifs. The love he has known as a young child matures him into a person that I can only hope will be compassionate, understanding, and accepting of all people and the world in which he lives. God, as our parent, calls us and prepares us for no less. We must be mindful that discipleship involves living our lives with integrity and faithfulness to God. As we come to a greater sense of self, finding our identity in God, we realize that we are developing the markers of our faith as we deepen how we understand God's call, that discipleship is shown in ways great and small in our daily living. In the passage today, Jesus is offering us rest should that development become heavy and make us weary, while also telling us there will be bumps along the way. However, when we have said yes to discipleship, we have said yes to the conviction that we are being called to live into a new vision of what we are to be and what we are to proclaim from what we have learned from Jesus' teachings. Last Sunday, I mentioned that the passage from Matthew of the day was high on my list of scripture that I offered to the Westdale faith community to think upon as you go forward into your future with your next minister. Today's scripture co-joins with last week's reading as one that I again bequeath to the faith community to think upon as Westdale future ministry beckons. As Westdale discerns what its discipleship surrendering means for the future ministry of the faith community, you do so as disciples unpacking the gospel call. To what is that gospel message calling the faith community, which invites Westdale ministry that is vital, is risky, authentic, faithful, compassionate, understanding, and accepting of one another and the world outside the building doors? The vital discipleship to which Jesus calls us in this passage means that you must not place ourselves in the role of a host or a hostess in a church whose ministries are concerned only with when to do the next maintenance project, rather than how to construct places of welcome and sustenance. The discipleship to which Jesus invites us in this passage requires that we stretch into our ministries by focusing on his message and realizing that we will find rest for carrying the burden of the gospel by living out the unique mission to which Jesus calls each of us. We do this best learning in community of discipleship that challenges one another as together we seek ways to tell the plain truths of our following of Christ and how those ways affect those around us like ripples in a pond or sometimes like tidal waves after an earthquake. Therefore, always we need to be aware of how our discipleship pushes us to think deeply about how we express the lessons that we have learned and continue to learn. In many ways, the leave-taking of one minister and the eventual arrival of a new minister is one of those value-filled times when the seeking is required and may best be done. I have come to understand my role as a theological and spiritual leader is to uplift the scripture stories as the textbook of our faith, and in particular, our journey as disciples of Christ. In the way that I hope to continue maturing my faith until the day I leave this earth, I hope that my time with you has upheld that our discipleship must mature into helping one another both personally and as a faith community, always to seek ways to live out our learning by sharing the good news of the demands and the comforts of God's call upon us as followers of Christ. It brings to mind the story I offered a few weeks ago of young Sally in the Peanuts comic strip. Sally was struggling with her memory verse for Sunday. She was absorbed in her thoughts to figure out when she remembered. Maybe it was something from the book of re-evaluation. She never did find the memory verse, but her parents told Sally that we should always read the Bible with the intent of re-evaluating our attitudes and actions to make sure they are in line with the truth of God's Word. The gift of today's reading is that many of us in our mature years and maturity as Christ followers recognize the pitfalls of our giving into cheap grace and reflection on the cross. Rather, our formation always is to focus on, or in Sally's parents' words, reevaluate the vital, risky, authentic, faithful, compassionate, understanding, and accepting of others in the discipleship to which God calls us. And as we surrender to all that the following of Christ calls us into, Christ is there, right with us, in the thick of it all, as we offer concrete messages and ways for others to see, to hear, and to feel for themselves the Christ in you, the God in you, the Christ in them, and the God. Christ is there always to offer his yoke of care, guidance, rest, strength, light, and love when we immerse ourselves fully and deeply in the discipleship of following him in our ministry, of offering God's vision of the world to all that we meet, this day and always. Amen. Let us pray. Christ, we bow before you in our worship places once more to give thanks. We gather together in heart, celebrating your presence in creation around us, in the flowing air, in the fertile earth, and in the running of the water. Together in heart, in our worship spaces, we are aware of countless prayers of joy and suffering that are uttered in these spaces. O Christ, you have inspired followers of your people the world over. Grant us with your continued presence that we also will be inspired followers. Christ, in your mercy, hear our prayers. O Jesus, you sat at table with the betrayed and rejected. We pray for those today who do not feel welcomed in our daily lives. O Christ, in your mercy, hear our prayers. O Jesus, you identified with the naked and with those who had no place to lay their heads. We pray for the thousands of homeless men and women, old and young, in our cities. Christ, in your mercy, hear our prayers. O Jesus, you belong to a refugee family, and we pray for the millions of displaced people in our world, for the opening of borders to the nationless. Christ, in your mercy, hear our prayers. O Jesus, you cared for your companions and for the little ones who surround you. We pray that we do likewise with those who come into our midst for care and companionship. Christ, in your mercy, hear our prayers. O Jesus, you prayed that we might be one as you and God are one. We pray that during our lives as followers, we may feel at home with one another and with you in our midst. Christ, in our mercy, hear our prayers. And now teach us, O Christ, to pray as brothers and sisters. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. What a privilege we have to share in God's mission to adapt and be responsible to the needs around us. Thank you for continuing to be diligent about putting aside your weekly offering and mailing some total amounts by check directly to the church so our treasurer can access these funds. As we offer our financial gifts, we continue to support the ministry and the service of Westdale United Church today and tomorrow. Our offertory prayer. Holy One, there are no limits to your goodness, no limits to your love. We have received beyond anything we could ask or expect, and joyfully we give in return. Bless these, our offerings, and remind us that as these gifts are used to bring compassion, hope, and justice, that you, Holy One, are discovered to be at work with us. Amen. At this time, we will hear our closing hymn being played by Brenda Shepherd. It's from Voices United 510. We have This Ministry.
This is our closing hymn, We Have This Ministry.
Thank you so much, Brenda. As I get ready to offer to you our sending out of this week, I would just like to let you know that I am on 1 week of study leave beginning on Monday, July the 6th, until Sunday, July the 12th. Reverend Joanna McCory, retired supply minister at Trinity United Church, is on call for any pastoral care emergencies. Please call the Westdale office at 705-743-9911 and listen to the message, which contains Reverend McCory's contact information should you require her to be in touch with you. Our own John McDonald will preside over the YouTube worship for Sunday, July the 12th. And so, our sending out. This is a sending out that comes out of the Iona Community Worship Book, and the Iona Community is that small dot of an island off the west coast of Scotland to which I had my sabbatical a few years ago. And these are the words. Be the great God between your shoulders to protect you in your going and your coming. Be the Son of Mary near your heart, and be the perfect Spirit upon you pouring. Amen. At this time, as I extinguish the Christ candle, we will hear our Brenda Shepherd play for us the Westdale choral blessing, Let There Be.